Hi and welcome back. We have already seen how you can calculate with images and how you can apply a certain calculation to an entire collection of images. But sometimes you need to apply a function on a collection in a specific order and where the output of the previous calculation is important for the next. For that, the script will need to go over the images one by one, which is done using the iteration function. Let's say, for example, that we want to assess the severeness of droughts, and we want to calculate what the maximum amount of consecutive dry days was in a given year. We can do this by getting a dataset with information about precipitation and iterating over those images. When no rain has fallen, we can add a 1 to that region, but when any amount of rain has fallen, we can reset the value of that region to 0. By doing this, we will get images that contain the number of consecutive dry days. But let's make this more concrete and put it into code. For the dataset I want to use, I will go with the Persian dataset. It contains global precipitation data from 1983 until the present, and uses artificial neural networks to estimate the daily precipitation based on other satellite data. I will select all images from the year 2017 and begin by writing the iteration function. It works very similar to the map function that we used in the previous example. When looking at the docs, we find that it requires an algorithm, meaning a function that has to be executed, and an initial state, meaning the initial object to start the iteration with. You can also iterate through feature collections and lists, and these work in exactly the same way. The function used in the iteration has a few requirements. It must take two arguments, one being the current element used in the iteration, and the second being the result of the previous iteration. If this isn't clear yet, it will be once we start writing that function. It is also important to note that this returns a computed object, not an image. If you want to use it as an image, you only have to declare it as one, since we already know it actually is one. So in the iteration function, we already typed the name of the function that we will create later. We wanted to add a 1 to a cell when it has not rained and reset the value to 0 when it has rained. For this, you'll have to create an initial image containing all cells with the value 0. You can do this by creating an ee.image containing all constant values of 0. We can quickly rename the band with the function rename, and now we have created the initial image with one band, which we can write in the iteration function. Also, do we need to cast the variable type to long, so it is of the same type as the other images. Since we have set all values to 0, it will automatically think it is binary. The function has to take an argument for the current image handled by the iteration, followed by an argument for the result of the previous iteration. So what we then want to do is check in the current image if the amount of precipitation is 0 or not. We can do this by remapping the image. We will check the docs real quick, and the arguments that are needed are the values we want to change, the values we want to change them to, and then potentially a default value and the band name of the band you want to remap. What we will do is remap all zeros to ones, and everything else to 0. We can then add this remapped image to the previous result. In that way, we add 1 to all cells that remain dry, and when we multiply by the mask again, we reset all cells to 0 when rain has fallen. For the first iteration, there is no previous result, so the initial image will be used. That is why we created an image containing only zeros. And when everything is done, we return this new result so it can be used in the next iteration. That's all you need to do for the iteration function. The exercise with the maximum amount of dry days is not yet complete, but let's see this result first. The iteration ran through all images and this was the last result. But this also means that a cell could have endured 100 consecutive dry days, but if it rained on the last day, the counter would have been reset. Somehow we need to get a list of all steps taken by the iteration and then take the maximum value a cell ever had. This is just a minor change in the code. Instead of returning the updated results to the next iteration, we can append the result to a list of images and let the next iteration take the last image from that list to work with. We will start by making the initial object a list instead of an image by simply putting the image in an ee.list. And in the function, we need to change it so that we apply the mask on the last image of that list. Getting item 0 would be the first item, so get negative 1 will select the last item from the list. And finally, we need to add this image to the original list and pass it on to the next iteration. Now our results will no longer be an ee.image, but an ee.list with all steps of the iteration. A final step will be to create an image collection out of this list so we can easily select all maximum values. Luckily, we can create an image collection with only a list of images, so we can add this as the argument. And at last, we will take the max values of the images in the collection. When printed on the map, we finally get the most consecutive dry days a certain cell has endured during the year 2017. But now we have to take into account that the iteration does not return an image but a list, so we have to define it as a list in the result. And that's it. I hope most of it was clear and you now understand how the iteration function works. The exercise went a little further than only explaining iterations, so I hope it didn't confuse anyone. If you still have questions about iterations or this example, make sure to let me know and I'll try to clear things out. Thanks for watching and until next time.